So in today's video, we'll be talking about reasoning models and whether they can tackle these complex tasks like navigating and escaping these beautiful mazes I just generated. It looks like we're seeing a new paradigm shift in how we approach problem solving with AI. And there is a new generation of language models called large reasoning models. The idea is simple. Instead of just jumping straight to an answer, the model first generates a bunch of tokens, thousands, even tens of thousands of tokens, just reasoning through the task. This reasoning step lets the model explore different solutions and reflect on its thought process and logic. That's called self-reflection. Only then the model produces the final answer, and the hope is more thinking equals better results. Sounds promising, right? But so far, it's not super clear how good these reasoning models really are and how much this extra reasoning step helps. Sure, there are some solid improvements on standard benchmarks, and reasoning models are now taking on some very complex tasks. OpenAI and Anthropic, for example, are live streaming their models on Twitch playing Pokemon. So yeah, if you're into AI, Pokemon and Twitch, I guess, you can watch them trying to catch them all in real time. But I tuned in for about half an hour yesterday and most of it was just the model standing in a corner of the map. I've never actually played Pokemon myself, so I couldn't really judge how well it was doing. The Twitch chat didn't seem very impressed though. So that's all interesting, but researchers are also trying to challenge this idea of reasoning models, which is a good thing by the way. Everyone's talking about this paper on the illusion of thinking now, maybe because of the catchy name or because it mentions things like the collapse of the reasoning models. But there are some other papers like this one, which says that a model's initial internal state, before it outputs a single token, can already predict what it's going to do. And if that's true, why bother generating and paying for thousands of tokens of reasoning? Well, let's stop speculating. I will show you a few experiments with reasoning and non-reasoning models that I run myself. And I decided to go with maze solving. You might have seen my previous videos where I did this with chess and other puzzles. So if you want more of that, let me know in the comments below. Maybe I will try chess again next time. But today, let's find out who's the best maze runner. To generate our mazes, I used a nice algorithm called randomize the first search, which starts with a full grid of walls and then carves out a path by randomly exploring the space, removing walls as it goes and backtracking whenever it hits a dead end, until the whole grid is explored. Then I randomly removed a few extra walls, which introduces loops, and that makes the maze trickier to solve. I then repeated this process for different grid sizes, so that we can slowly increase the difficulty when testing the models. Now, let's talk about the models. Obviously, I would love to benchmark every LLM out there, but that's not really possible. So I picked a solid mix from different companies, focusing on comparing reasoning and non-reasoning versions. From Google, I included Gemini 2.5 Flash, which is actually great for this experiment, because this model lets you enable or disable the thinking mode. So that already gives us two models. I will use orange for reasoning and yellow for non-reasoning individuals. I also tested Gemini 2.5 Pro, Google's most powerful LLM right now. Unfortunately, that one has always reasoning turned on, so we cannot have its non-reasoning counterpart. But let's include it anyway to see how strong the latest Google model really is. From Alibaba, I picked Quen Plus, which is their strongest model that supports this reasoning toggle. I also included Quen Max, which is Alibaba's largest model, but that one for change doesn't support reasoning. But again, let's see how it stacks up. From Anthropic, I went with Claude for Sonnet, both with and without reasoning enabled. Yes, I know that Claude for Opus is stronger, but it's quite expensive right now, so Sonnet it is. OpenAI does things a bit differently. They don't let you toggle reasoning on the same model, instead they have separate models for reasoning. So I used O4 Mini for reasoning and GPT 4.1 as its non-reasoning counterpart. And finally, I also added two open weight models, Mistral Large from Mistral AI and Llama 3.37TB from Meta. Neither of these support reasoning, but they are large, widely used, and I often include them in my own research. So I want to see how they hold up against the high-end proprietary models. And I think that gives us a pretty decent lineup with 12 models in total. Oh, and there are two things I should mention about the prompting. First, the models don't see the whole maze. They only see their current location, so it's as if you were actually in the maze. So that makes it much more challenging. And second, I only asked the model for directions in junctions and dead ends. So for example, here I would give GPT 4.1 options to give either two steps west or one step north. Then I would ask whether it wants to go one step south, two steps west or one step east. then 2 steps north and 2 steps east, and so on. I'm keeping the entire conversation in the prompt so the model can see all its previous decisions and has access to the previous information about the maze. So if it can reason well, it should be able to understand what has and hasn't been explored and effectively navigate the maze until it finds the exit. But enough explanations. Let's test all our models in the smallest maze. It's gonna be a little bit crowded now with all 12 models at once, but don't worry, I have a feeling that not all of them will make it to the next round. And that was 100 decisions for each model. That's enough to conclude that 7 models could find a way out, but 5 of them got forever lost in the maze. And why stop after 100? Why not 200 or more? Well, if I run a search algorithm, it shows me that the shortest path takes only 8 decision steps. So 100 must be more than enough. And all 3 non-reasoning models would probably not solve the maze even if I gave them 1000 steps. Because look at them. Completely lost. No idea what they're doing. The darker the path, the more time they spend on each tile. And you can see that they all got stuck looping in this corner for some reason. Now, the reasoning counterparts for Gemini and Quen also failed the maze, but both managed to explore the maze much better. That's already showing us that the reasoning is doing something right. But I was wondering why it failed to find the exit, because for example Quen got to this spot 3 times, so close to the exit, and it made the wrong choice every single time. So I looked at the reasoning output to see whether it can shed some light into its reasoning, and found a bunch of nonsense. For example, the model likes going east for some reason. It mentioned things like east is a common path, or that it's the safest bet, without any additional explanation. It also said that sometimes moving east can be part of a right-hand or left-hand rule, which is true, but so can any other direction. And I found some really vague sentences too, like, if I go east now, maybe that leads somewhere, or perhaps west, but maybe moving west here could lead to a new path, or east, right? What kind of reasoning is that? So you can see that it generates something called a reasoning text, but that doesn't mean it's actually thinking and reasoning.
The ability to speak does not make you intelligent.
But it's weird because there is a clear improvement between the non-reasoning and reasoning Quen models. So it's clearly doing something. Okay, but back to our maze, we have our 7 winners, so let's make the maze bigger and test them again. And we can see that most of them found the exit this time. That shows we're left with the models that can understand the task, the previous steps, and they don't get stuck in some weird loops. Well, okay, all of them but one. This loopy dead end turned out fatal for Quen Max. It kind of shows that some models are less robust. They can perform well in most scenarios, but once in a while they encounter something unexpected and they can completely fail. So that's another open weight model out, but we're still left with Mistral. And Mistral did really well. 123 billion parameter model, which is much less than Quen Max, and look how good it is, not bad at all. Alright, clearly this maze wasn't a big enough challenge, so let's go bigger. And so, 2 models didn't make it, Mistral and a non-reasoning GPT. First, Mistral lost after 103 steps, because it self-declared a victory, saying, congratulations, you found the exit. Well, I guess that's one strategy. But you cannot fool me, Mistral. And with GPT, I let it run for up to 200 steps. But it just kept running in circles. Interestingly, both models got stuck on the same problem. They didn't find this turn, which would eventually lead to the exit. And again, when I put them side by side, the reasoning version of GPT is just doing much better, with almost no overlap, effectively exploring the maze. And now it's time to test our largest maze. We only have 1 non-reasoning model left, Claude Sonnet, and 3 reasoning models, Gemini Pro, Claude Sonnet, and GPT-4o Mini. Here is the shortest path to the exit, and you can see this maze is not easy at all. Well, let's see what happens. Thank you. Wow, only one model made it out. Gemini 2.5 Pro is the winner. And the others didn't make it, and when I put them side by side, you will see why. Gemini's exploration is almost flawless. No mistakes, just steadily exploring new paths until it reaches the exit. I'm quite impressed. The Claude models did fine, the reasoning one was arguably slightly better, but neither managed to find this turn here. And lastly, GPT-4o Mini. Well, I'm not sure what happened, but it just flopped and started running back and forth. I wish I could see the full reasoning output here, like I could with Qwen before, but Qwen was actually the only model that showed its full reasoning. OpenAI hides it and only gives short reasoning summaries. And they didn't show anything interesting. Gemini also gives summaries, but they were a bit more useful. In a few cases, I noticed it was tracing its movement using a coordinate system, and it even generated a nice summary of previous steps and locations. It also mentioned that its primary strategy is depth-first search. So if that's what Gemini used, without me telling it to, I'm not surprised it did so well. Anyways, that's all for today. Hope you liked the video and learned something. Let me know in the comments below what you think about reasoning models, and thank you for watching.